go.
Eric Turnbow of Olympia, Washington, saved up his whole life so that he could visit the famed Abbey Road crosswalk in London. But it wasn't enough for Eric to just walk across the road like the Beatles did. He had to do it his own special way.
Here's Eric about to walk in his hands across Abbey Road.
Hey!
Try it again.
Oh, no, I put my shoulder out. Oh.
Are you in pain?
Yeah.
There's a hospital right down the road.
The British hospital didn't charge Eric anything for his stay. And only about $10 for all the way cool drugs they gave him.
We all swung up, as Elvis would say.
I'm gonna be okay.
I decided to go to Great Britain to find out how a hospital stay could be free and drugs could cost only $10.
I come in here and I have a prescription, and it requires 30 pills. How much is that?
It's £6.65. That's the standard charge.
£6.65. So that's like, what, $10 or so?
Yeah.
What if I needed 60 pills? How much is it?
Same charge.
120 pills.
£6.65 still.
It doesn't matter. How many pills?
No.
What if it's like an HIV drug or a cancer drug?
It's still £6.65. If they are either under 16 or over 60, they're automatically exempt.
So only a working adult who earns enough money pays the £6.65, and everybody else gets their medication for free.
That's right.
There's no money being exchanged here.
Nothing.
There's no money being exchanged.
I'm over 60.
And
you don't pay.
What's the purpose of the cash register? I'm just wondering, where's the bread and the milk and the candy in here? I can't pick up any laundry detergent here.
No. I haven't been trained for that many years to be selling detergent, so no.
I next went to a state-run hospital operated by the National Health Service.
I'm due in 7 weeks, and I get 6 months off paid, and then I can have 6 months off unpaid as well. So I'm actually taking a year.
Well, that sounds like a luxury where I'm from.
Oh, really? It's not like that in the US? No, not at all, no.
So what do you pay for a stay here?
No one pays. They were asking, how do people pay? And I said, well, there isn't. You don't, you just leave.
It's national insurance.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's no bill at the end of it, as it were.
Even with insurance, there's bound to be a bill somewhere. So where's the billing department?
There isn't really a billing department.
There's no such thing as a
billing
department.
Yeah. What'd they charge you for that baby?
Sorry.
You gotta pay before you can get out of here, right?
No.
Everything's on
this is
NHS,
anything.
So, yeah, you know,
no,
it's not America.
Maybe I'd have better luck in the part of the hospital where things can get seriously expensive. This guy broke his ankle. How much will this cost him?
Sorry?
The emergency room visit. It'll have some huge bill when he's done, right?
Here. NHS, everything is free.
I'm asking about hospital charges.
Yeah.
And you're laughing at me.
Because I was never asked this question in emergency department, that's why.
I was starting to fall for this everything is free bit, and then I discovered this.
So this is where people come to pay their bill when they're done staying in the hospital.
No, this is the NHS hospital, so you don't pay the bill.
You get to just go home. Why does it say cashier here if people don't have to pay a bill?
All we have is a little man who stands behind a counter and gives people money if they've had to pay for transport.
Those who have reduced means get their travel expenses reimbursed.
Thank you.
So in British hospitals, instead of money going into the cashier's window, money comes out.
The criteria for letting you out of the hospital are not if you've paid your bill. The criteria are you fit to go and are you going somewhere safe?
Clearly, I was just the butt of a joke here. What I needed was a good old-fashioned American who would have some understanding.
Well, I first came to London in 1992, and we just ended up staying, and we had three children here. I had them all on the NHS, which is the National Health Service, the British National Health Service. I think, like a lot of Americans, assumed that socialized medicine was just bottom of the rung treatment, that, you know, that's the only possible way. It would be, you know, dingy and horrible, and it would be like the Soviet Union. I mean, that's kind of how, it's terrible. That's what I thought.
That's what I thought, too. After having a baby, it's right back to the wheat fields. And then it occurred to me that back home in America, we've socialized a lot of things. I kind of like having a police department and fire department and the library, and I got to wondering, why don't we have more of these free, socialized things, like healthcare?
When did this whole idea that every British citizen should have a right to healthcare?
Well, if you go back, it all began with democracy. Before we had the vote, all the power was in the hand of rich people. If you had money, you could get health care, education, look after yourself when you were old. And what democracy did was to give the poor the vote, and it moved power from the marketplace to the polling station, from the wallet to the ballot. And what people said was very simple. They said, in the 1930s, we had mass unemployment, but we don't have unemployment during the war. If you can have full employment by killing Germans, why can't you have full employment by building hospitals, building schools, recruiting nurses, recruiting teachers? If you can find money to kill people, you can find money to help people.
Right.
This leaflet that was issued, very, very straightforward.
What year was this?
This was 1948. Your new National Health Service begins on the 5th of July. What is it? How do you get it? It will provide you with all medical, dental, and nursing care. Everyone, rich or poor, man, woman, or child, can use it or any part of it. There are no charges except for a few special items. There is no insurance qualifications, but it is not a charity. You are paying for it mainly as taxpayers, and it will relieve your money worries in times of illness. Now, somehow that the few words sum the whole thing up.
I was amazed when he said this all started in 1948. The British had just come out of a devastating experience through World War II. The country was destroyed and nearly bankrupt. They had nothing. In just one 8-month period, over 42,000 civilians lost their lives. What we went through in 2 hours on 9/11, they went through nearly every single day. Remember how we all felt after 9/11? All of us pulling together? I guess that's how they felt. And the first way that they decided to pull together after the war was to provide free medical care for everyone.
Even Mrs. Thatcher said, "The National Health Service is safe in our hands." It's as non-controversial as votes for women. Nobody could come along and say, "Why should women have the vote now?" Because people wouldn't have it, and they wouldn't have in Britain. They wouldn't accept the deterioration or destruction of the National Health Service.
You mean if Thatcher or Blair had said, "I'm going to dismantle National Health Care"?
There'd have been a revolution, yeah.
A report from the American Medical Association.